months called one of my nightmares out of paper. I thought it was beautiful, I put it on a record cover. And I tried to tell him that he had a sense of color and composition so magnificent. And he said, thank you, please, but your flattery is truly not becoming me. Your eyes are poor, you're blind, you see. No beauty could have come from me. I'm a waste of breath, of space, of time. I knew a woman, she was dignified and true. Her love for a man was one of her many virtues. So one day she found out that he had lied. She decided the rest of her life from that point on would be a lie. But she was grateful for everything that had happened. She was anxious for all that would come next. But then she wept, what did you expect in that big old house with the car she kept? And such is life, she often said, with one day leading to the next, you get a little closer to your death, which was fine with her. She never got upset, and with every day she may have left, she would never clean another mess or fold his shirts or look her best. She was free to waste away alone. Last night my brother, he got drunk and drove, and this cop, he pulled him off to the side of the road. And he said, officer, officer, you got the wrong man. No, I'm a student of medicine, a brother, a folk singer, you don't understand. And no matter, you should be thankful. Your carelessness, it is something awful. And no, I can't just let you go. And though your father's name is known, your decisions now, they are yours alone. You're nothing but a stepping stone on a path to death, to loss, to shame. The last few months I've been living with this couple. You know the kind who buy everything in doubles. Well, they fit together like a puzzle. I love their love, and I'm thankful that someone actually receives the prize that was promised by all those fairy tales that drugged us. And they still took me. I'm sick, lonely, no laurel tree, just green and evil. My number come up eventually, like blood, some kind of lottery, where you scratch and see what's underneath. It's sorry. Just one cherry, I'll play again. You'll get lucky. So I've been hanging out down by the train's depot. No, I don't ride, I sit and watch the people there. They remind me of wind up cars in motion. They're where they're spinning, turning, jerking each other off for positions. And I wanna scream out that it all is nonsense. Hey, your life's one trap! Can't you see it's pointless? Just then my knees get under me, my head feels weak, and suddenly it's clear to see it's not them but me who's lost myself. Identity as I hide behind these books I read while scribbling my poetry, like art could save a wretch like me with some idealized ecology that no one could hope to achieve. And I'm never real. It's just a step to me. Everything I'm painting is trite and cheap and a waste. The pain of taking the time. Now I park my car down by the cathedral, where the floodlights point up at the steeples. Quiet practice, it was filling up with people. I could hear the sound escaping as an echo, sloping off the ceiling at an angle. And when the voices blended, they sounded like angels. I hope there's some room still in the middle. But when I lift my voice up now to reach them, the range is too high way up there in your heaven. So I hold my tongue, forget the song. I tie my shoes, I start walking off, and I'll try to just keep moving on with my broken heart and my absent God. And I have no faith, but it's all I want to be loved and believe.